Brian, first of all, your current business trends for the month of March of 2021, you entitled it, "The Recovery Strengthens." This is if we're already into it. There are some who are saying we're not. There are others, and you're one of them, that says we are.
Well, the industrial market is definitely strengthening, and that's what I keep track of. I survey industrial purchasing agents on the west side of the state of Michigan, and the industrial economy has fully recovered as near as I can tell right now, except for a few pockets. Obviously, we make a lot of office furniture on this side of the state of Michigan, and they're not doing as well because we're redefining what the office is. But our main cyclical industry, which is automotive parts, has more than recovered. In fact, they have excess demand right now in some quarters. And so that's why I say we are on a roll right now. Our peak was, of course, January, which is typical of coming out of a recession, that we have a spike that says, hey, we're out of the recession now, and then we settle back from that. And I didn't expect this strong of a number this month, but we will take it because, again, the economy and the industrial end is recovering.
Yeah, we'll certainly take that as well. There were some concerns when a couple of weeks ago when that barge got stuck in the Suez Canal, and it was going to cause some issues with shipping. The microchips, some say, was not available. And I saw reports that some of the car makers were sort of holding off some of the, you know, we can't fill these orders because we don't have the microchips to put in the things. How much of a concern, if any, was the Suez situation with, you know, the trickle-down effect to some of the auto parts makers in these parts, based on what your polling showed?
Well, it showed that, of course, the worldwide market took notice of that. And it also points out how fragile this supply chain is that we have running around the whole world right now. We've had trouble coming from the Far East because this is where the majority of our chips come from. Part of it has been production, inadequate amounts of production, but part of it has just been plain shipping as well. Stuff is getting held up at the ports on the West Coast, and so far, nobody's come up with any real easy solutions to this. This has, of course, influenced the automotive makers because all cars are full of computer chips right now, and if you're missing one chip, you can't ship the car.
Now, the thing is, though, and you brought up a very good point, and we have really not seen a lot of publicity or coverage of it, is the logjam in Los Angeles right now of shipping. And that is almost as much of a problem as anything that would have happened over on the other side of the world.
Our respondents to our survey are puzzled. They say, why isn't somebody working on this problem? Because the problem began long before the coronavirus hit. And the coronavirus simply exacerbated this. There is no talk right now in the government circles of saying, oh, gee, we got to do something about the jam up in the ports. In fact, they seem to be just hoping that it's going to go away. And I suppose over time it may, but the government still needs to step in and say, we need more inspectors. We need to figure out where the bottlenecks are and get those bottlenecks cleared.
How much of a factor with the respondents that you've talked to, Brian, has the situation with Canada caused? Because, you know, obviously travel is certainly affected, but what about commerce? Has that really been a major factor? Because a lot of things that we make or we ship go to the Great White North.
Well, in this month's report, I pointed out that the Canadian survey of purchasing managers hit an all-time high this past month. Their economy in the industrial market is on a roll. Obviously, they've got the same problems in the consumer market, i.e., restaurants that are shut down, movie theaters that are shut down, sports venues that can't open and that type of thing. They have that problem. But what we are shipping to them right now seems to be going fairly smooth. So that part of it is coming okay. And so far, we have not had the bottlenecks at the Canadian border with customs that we've had on the West Coast.
One final thing, Brian Long, the I word. And yeah, there's a generation at least that doesn't know about the I word. The I word is inflation. We all, for those of us of a certain certain vintage, we remember Gerald Ford's win buttons, whip inflation now. How much of a concern is that we could see the I word coming back, especially with some of the government spending plans? And I know you're not a person that deals with stocks and bonds and stuff like that, but industrial inflation could really lead to consumer inflation, and then we got to pull out those win buttons again.
Over the last 40 years or so, industrial inflation hasn't spilled over into the consumer market because we've had foreign competition. It was a pretty simple rule back in the 1950s that if industrial inflation picked up, almost immediately consumer inflation would follow within 3 to 6 months. That is simply not the case anymore, and we are not geared for that. On the other hand, I point out that we've had some huge spikes in the industrial market as far as inflation, and it's gone almost unnoticed over the last 3 or 4 years. So for that reason, I say we have to step back and take a look. The big problem that I have is that the industrial market is one market, the consumer market is another. That consumer market is going to face inflation with the overseas market that generally moderates the situation because of the rise in the price of many of the industrial commodities that we are talking about. So there is this possibility. Our consternation now is that the Federal Reserve seems to be assuming that that's simply not going to happen, or that if it does, they're going to be reluctant to do anything about it.
Dr. Brian Long, as always, we appreciate your thoughts about the West Michigan economy based on your perspective as you poll purchasing managers in the Grand Rapids and Kalamazoo area every month for your current business trends update. Wish you and your family well. And if all goes well, let's do this again next month.
I'll look forward to that.